Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to Station 8, where we are going to talk some joints. Specifically, we are going to focus on the sutures, and specifically the largest sutures associated with the skull. So we are looking at a superior view here. This is going to be anterior, and this is going to be posterior. I know this because this is the larger frontal bone, and you can only see a little bit of the occipital from a truly superior view. And we can see three sutures here. We can see this more horizontally located coronal or frontal suture that is going to be between the frontal bone and the paired parietal bones. And this suture that is running mostly down the midline, but between the two parietal bones, will be the sagittal suture. And lastly, you can see a bit of the lambdoid or lambdoidal suture that is going to be between the paired parietal bones as well as the occipital bone. So this is the occipital bone, and this suture is the lambdoid. Looking at a lateral view, you can see again the coronal or frontal suture between the parietal bone, the right parietal bone here, and the frontal bone. And you can see another suture that we haven't discussed quite yet, and this is the squamous suture. And this is going to be between the temporal bone and the parietal bone. And this is a much flatter type of suture. It's almost like the temporal bone was kind of pushed into place over the parietal bone, so it will appear a lot flatter in terms of its location. And there is one craniometric landmark that I want to note here, and it's basically where you have the meeting point of four different bones. So where the parietal bone, the frontal bone, the temporal bone, and this right here is the greater wing of the sphenoid bone, where these three meet is going to be the craniometric landmark referred to as pterion. Now, there are craniometric landmarks throughout the skull. In fact, I did a good amount of my dissertation really focusing on measuring the distance between craniometric landmarks. But this one is of particular clinical importance because if you have a fracture that occurs around pterion, there is going to be a branch of the middle meningeal artery that is just deep to the pterion landmark. And so that could lead to a cut or a tear in the middle meningeal artery, which could lead to an epidural hematoma or hemorrhage. So this is a clinical landmark or a craniometric landmark that comes up often in a clinical context. Lastly, let's look at a posterior view and just get our bearings in terms of what bones we're looking at. These are the two parietal bones, and you have a much better view of the occipital bone here. You can see a bit of that sagittal suture running between the two parietal bones, and then this very complex suture right here between the parietal bones and the occipital bone is going to be the lambdoid or lambdoidal suture. And sometimes you'll see almost like different sets of bones that are kind of within the suture. Those are called sutural bones. You don't actually have one on this particular donor, but that's not at all uncommon to see. There are many, many more sutures associated with the cranium, but these are the largest ones and the ones that I am going to have you identify for this course. So review these. If you have any questions, please reach out, and thank you for your time and attention.